Hello everyone, this is Alvin, your instructor for this session. Today we will learn some basic date and time functions in Microsoft Excel. If you really like the video, please like, share and subscribe, and request you to please watch this video till end. Let's start. First, we will learn how to calculate current system date and time automatically. To calculate current system date, we will use Ctrl semicolon from the keyboard. You will get the current system date. To know the current time of a system, you need to press Ctrl Shift and semicolon from your keyboard. You will get the current time of a system. And if you want date as well as time in a single cell, you will press Ctrl semicolon. We will get the date and then press space and again Ctrl Shift semicolon. We will get the current date and time in a single cell. Please remember, this will not auto update. This will only take the current time or date of that particular time. Next, we will see how to format date and time by using custom formatting. If you want to apply your custom formatting, press Ctrl 1 from your keyboard. You will get format cell option. If we select a date at right side, pick whichever you want to apply. You can see the selected format has been applied. You can press also Alt OE from your keyboard to get this custom formatting. Likewise, there are so many custom formats available. For date and time, you can select the same and apply custom formatting. There are also other ways as well to display the date and time in custom way by using text function. We can showcase the date or time in different ways. We will see with some examples. In first example, we can derive day from the date using text function. You have to write DD in double quote in the format text. Likewise, we can determine weekdays of the date in the short format by using DDD in the string format, that is in quote. If you press D four times, you will get long format. Likewise, you can also give the same to derive month and the year, as you can see in the below examples. Like date, we can also format text for time as well. There are some formats which you can apply. In the first example, you can see we gave in MMDDYYYY format in two ways. And below we can get hour, minute and seconds format. So this is all about formatting. The next function which we'll see is date function. The date function returns a date from year, month and day supplied from user. Let's see the use. We will use equal to date, select a year, then month and the day. In below, instead of selecting cells, we can give manually as well. We will use equal to date, open parenthesis, select year, then month and day. Like date, we have time function in which we have to select hour, minute and seconds, which is provided. This is used frequently to derive time from CSV file, which is given in text format. This is very useful function. Another dynamic function which is used in day-to-day life, that is today function. Today function returns today's date. And it is very useful because it keeps changing automatically as per the current date of the system. Syntax is very simple. You have to press equal to today and close the function parenthesis. You will get the current date. You can also subtract the days from the date as it is a dynamic function. This function used frequently while working with formula. Like today function, there is another function which returns date and also time. You can use now function and it will return date and time. It is useful when you have to calculate date as well as time. For example, login date and time. Next function which we'll see is year function. By using year function, we can derive year from the given date. Syntax is equal to year, and instead of serial number, you have to select date. That's it. Like year, we can also derive month by using month function. And to derive day from the date, we will use day function. The syntax is all the same. Like year, month, and day, we can also derive hour, minutes, and seconds. Syntax is same. To derive hour, you will use hour function. Minute to derive minutes, and second to derive seconds from given time. These are very basic but very useful time functions. Cool. Moving to next date function. That is YEARFRAC. It is used to calculate the fraction of years by number of days between 2 days. As you can see on the screen, we have start date and end date. So the syntax is press equal to YEARFRAC, open parentheses, select start date, comma, end date. By default, it will take 360 days, that is whole days. And if you want 365 days, like in the below example, we will calculate age. Just select your birth date in start date and end date as current date. And in the basis, you will select as 3, that is actual 365 days. You will get current age by using YEARFRAC. Next, which we will learn another date function, that is EDATE. We can add or increase the date by adding month. You can see we will extend the date by 2 months. So in output, current date increased by 2 months. The next very useful and important function is EOMONTH, that is end of month. It is very useful to calculate end of the month date. And plus point is we can also increase month count in the same function. For example, if you want to auto calculate the after 2 month end date, we will specify start date and month as 2. You will get exact ending date of the month. And if you want to calculate for existing month, you can keep blank or you have to just press, that is comma, you can just write comma 0. So we'll get the current month's ending date. This session last date function which we'll see is WEEKNUM. It is useful to calculate the week number of the month for a given date. Syntax is equal to WEEKNUM, select date, and in return type, you will give week begins day. Select the same and you will get exact week number for the given day. So in this way, you can calculate the week number for the given date. This is some information related to return type numbers. you can take a screenshot or have a look. We have learned all the functions related to time and date from our agenda. If you find any difficulties or queries, please feel free to comment. We are happy to answer them. That's all for today. This is Arvind Lad signing off. Keep learning, keep growing with Arvind Techs. Bye-bye.